Welcome, it's Open House Thursday on Your View. I am Tokpe Mark Odige, and I have my lovely co-host here with me, Cyril in the building. Cyril,
hello, Cyril.
I'm ready for you today.
How are you doing?
I'm ready.
Yo,
I'll contextualize as usual.
No,
can you solve them?
Yo, the yo. Last time I danced to this song on this set,
you looked funny.
I went back feeling very drained and strange.
So Jimaka is in high spirits. What's up?
I'm in high spirits because regardless of all the negativity and envy and jealousy that there is around, you realize that you need enemies for you to progress in life. I read that yesterday, you know, and I just thank God that he fights my battles. Anytime there's any negative energy towards me, God just blocks it. He fights it all the time. So because of that alone, I'm in high spirits.
I think it's a decision we need to make to remain happy no matter what. And I'm encouraging myself on that every day, that you choose to be happy regardless. This year, see, talk.
She's
because
the
there's something she wants to announce that will make me feel good.
She's been coaching me on Sit Right.
Now, okay, yes. I have a personal makeup artist called Dupe. And I have a personal hairstylist
called
Tokpe Mark Odige.
So we are opening our salon. So after yesterday's discussion of finding other options of making money, I decided to explore my natural talent of doing
hair. Let us zoom in. Zoom in.
That was done by my humble self.
By her very humble self.
Yes. And now I want to start charging. I don't charge
where,
too much.
Where is
just 1,000 naira.
Where is the salon?
Forget. The salon is as the spirit leads.
As the spirit leads. Strictly natural hair.
If you are in your car, the salon will meet you there.
Yes.
You know, this is the best salon ever because it is on demand. Once you just call, make a phone call, you are right there. Thank you so much, Tokpe. I really, really love my hair. Thank
but
you so much.
If you do makeup, if you tie gilly, I think it's a natural advancement for you to also start to make.
So progress. We're making progress. Good progress. Positive one at that. Cyril, you're still looking at me like
you did
something.
Not ask me how my day was.
I'm so sorry, Cyril.
You know the drill now.
Marginalization.
So
you're marginalizing me.
As the only man.
Because I'm the only man on the stage.
Please don't go and join militants on top of this matter.
It's not you're not in the system.
That is making it dull.
How can you be marginalized? You're the only one eating our
granite. I give up because
I'm moving on.
Wait, let me attack you.
It's okay.
That attack will take place after the break. We'll take a quick break. When we return, we'll do the newspaper reviews. Stay with us, we'll be right back. Welcome back. It's time for Front Page Review, and we'll be starting off with the punch. Major headline: attack on Buhari. Nigerians back in Baka says hunger, poverty unbearable. If hardship continues, President APC would lose in 2019. That's from Balarabe and others. In other news, we have army arrest top Boko Haram members. ISIS names al-Banawi new leader. EFCC grills Nnadi Usman. Court jails Fayose's ally. And in other news, we have Lagos Ibadan Expressway. Robbers strike again. Motorists abandon vehicles. We can restructure Nigeria, says General Gowon. Dogara gives each rep $25,000. I had to make noise.
Please take the ride under it.
To support him. Mm-hmm. That's from Jubrin. Mm-hmm. Jonathan meets Buhari, says he'll speak after corruption cases. And you can't miss the picture.
Pensioners.
Two Benue retirees slumped during pension protest. This is really, really bad.
Mm. Yesterday, they staged a protest to fight against them. I think for the past 11 months, they've not been paid any of their allowances and all that. So in that process, two of the retirees pensioners, actually slumped and they collapsed. This matter happens all the time, where people that are supposed to be paid, you know, what is due to them, they are not being paid. So it's a really sad story.
But I wanted to take Nigerians supporting him yesterday and saying that, yes, well, we support you on this one. But you, when you were supporting President Buhari for the elections, did you not know that he was not the Messiah? Mm. You know, that's what that the major headline says that Nigerians are saying that by 2019, if hunger and the economy does not improve, no one is going to be voting for the president.
So I wanted to quickly talk about the Lagos-Ibadan Expressway. Because it was on the front page of Punch yesterday, and we didn't mention it. And this time around again, there's another robbery. I think it's on that Wawa Long Bridge. That what happened was that there was a gridlock, and all of a sudden, armed robbers came and they started attacking people. So what the motorists did was they came out of their vehicles and some of them ran into the bush. But some of them, when they now noticed that these robbers didn't have ammunition or whatever, they took stones and they were trying to stone them. From one of the eyewitnesses, she was saying that there's a construction going on that road. Mm. So there's something that is packed on that road that has reduced the, size of the lane. Mm. So people are forced to slow down at that particular time. And that place is known, Bukola Samuel-Wemimo was saying this morning that that place is known for not only robbery, even ritual killings and all that. So a lot of negative kidnapping as well. So, I mean, since they know that that place is prone to insecurity attacks. And attacks like that, I think what the government should do is deploy heavy policemen there in the meantime before they finish fixing
it's,
that
it's
road.
It's in between Lagos and
yes, is that Ogun long
state.
Bridge?
It's not yeah. Lagos State, right?
Yes, yeah. but it's a federal road.
What you notice is that the trend of crime that is prevailing now is taking place at the border corridors of Lagos and Ogun. You will hear the Lagos State Governor say they're going to shut down some places, they're going to do this and that. The Ogun State Government too, perhaps, is doing it. But I think it's high time that they come, that they came together to say, let's form a bi-statal sort of commission.
Collaboration.
To synergize.
Yes.
Because it's not, even if the military comes from all the way from Abuja to do air bombardment,
why are we always
they only work based on intelligence, eh?
It's not a military thing, it's a police force.
The threat on the ground has assumed the proportion that requires military might, not just police. I mean, if you had the police are coming to seek help, how you see? So the
point what are you trying to say? Military is tougher.
People hear military.
And they are more.
They know that one thing and
or we should go back to community policing, which is what everybody has been advocating for.
But of course, if you see what's going on in Kaduna, in Adamawa, even Lagos here, I think that every community
should have
without being told, has to have his own standby force. You can't take it away anymore.
Moving on to the next paper, that's The Nation. No alternative to United Nigeria, says Jonathan. I'm working with others for peace in Niger Delta. In other news, we have Dogara bribing members with $25,000.
And they say that is a lie. There's a ride on that.
It's a lie, says Zakari. No, I have to. Let me know. I have to. My voice has to go down on that one. It's a lie, says Zakari. I shared Dezani 23 billion naira poll cash among Northeast states. That's from Mrs. Nnadi Usman. In other news, we have Dasuki Fayose Obanikoro took Office of National Security Advisors 4.6 billion naira. EFCC arraigns Agbele. Government to generate 558 billion naira from Badagry ports. I saw that in the news yesterday. Good news. Ajimobi, Oyo can't pay workers' salary. State to improve IGR. And you can't miss the picture of our present president, President Muhammadu Buhari, and our former president, Dr. Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, at the State House Abuja yesterday. So what story are we going to take?
That Usman Dezani.
She
said that she shared some funds that were given to her by Dezani, and she shared it according to the allocation. Dezani stated, okay, this is where you need to carry this one to, this is where you need to carry that one to. However, in that report, it was stated that Dezani's, that fund that Dezani gave to her was actually gotten from, collectively from different oil companies.
Oh, okay.
And so that was what was stated in that report. So we are not sure whether the 23 billion is part of the money we are looking for, but from the report, he said that she got some fundings from different oil companies. They came together and they funded. So she, her job was just to disburse. She was saying that at the EFCC office, because she was invited.
I want to talk about Ajimobi, please.
I think what we need to do is, beyond the question of federal government, you know, like we said on Monday, that the federal government should take over these payments. Where that may not be feasible in the short term, I think that the House of Assembly of each of these states can pass a law saying that as soon as this allocation comes to the state,
priority is given to salaries.
Yes, that before even the governor takes out what is going to budget and spend, worker salaries should be paid. How do they put it in finance now? Should be paid automatically,
Like a standing order.
Automatically, you know. So I mean, we don't have to be going through this route of a governor removing money for his dog, removing money for his for workers of frivolous things before thinking of workers' welfare.
Rochas Okorocha State has ordered that workers should only work for 3 days
and farm for 2 days.
And I've not seen that in the papers.
It is in the papers today. Maybe not on
not on the front page.
What was in the papers today was that his people are rejecting the offer.
He's also saying they cannot go
because it is a frivolous story. Serious editor is going to make it a frontline story. That's a fact.
Next paper, Vanguard. Major headline. There are even two. I don't know which one to take first. I'll start with scandal.
Because it screams.
Yes. Screaming. Nigeria's Olympic football team in trouble. Presidency reacts. I hear they're stranded. And we have menace of vandals in Arepo, Igodo, Ikorodu. Ambode threatens lockdown of affected areas to suspend commercial activity in crime-prone areas. IGP vows to deploy gunboats to patrol creeks. I remember we have just 2 gunboats in Lagos, right? Just 2. In other news, we have Jonathan meets Buhari, harps on Nigeria's unity, anti-graft war. I'll expose corrupt lawyers, NBA president. Forex policy, others shut down corporate profits in first half of 2016.
Very sad. Very, very sad. If our corporations are in problems, then the economy is definitely in problems. I was going to take the major headline of our footballers being stranded in Atlanta, and it was sad news because the federal government had been embarrassed by athletes going on GoFundMe to raise money, to go represent Nigeria at the Rio Olympics. Anyways, just yesterday, I saw Senator Common Sense, Ben Murray Bruce, saying that we have 11 presidential jets. Why do we have our players stranded? Well, in trying to solve the issue, I saw in this article in the Vanguard that the presidency is thinking of sending one of our presidential jets to Atlanta to airlift the players.
They have a match tomorrow, Jimoke.
Less than
well, the president, the football team has a match tomorrow, and they are stranded in Atlanta.
Let me shock you.
The presidential jets may have left.
Siasia was robbed in Atlanta. There, his phones and cash and other valuables were taken from his car. The minister went to Atlanta and said that he didn't even know how they got to Atlanta. What are they doing there?
And then went on to say
that he was firing Siasia from heading the team and appointing John Mikelobi to lead the team.
In the middle of the game. Did you change goalposts?
Talk back. You can accuse me of being petty, but if that long had been a senator or House of Reps member, by now we know that.
Have recalled him.
Yes. Not just recalled him. By now, you would have had some case against him. Some people would have already begun to point fingers at him.
Or raised allegations.
I'm concerned and bothered. This minister, if he does not know what he's doing, his boss should have fired him by now.
But the president.
His boss should have fired him by now.
The president is his boss now.
Yes, because as it is
because
right now.
Because obviously, the Olympic thing is his first major outing. Leading Nigeria into any international tournament. These failures had been there from the beginning, but this tournament has just brought him to the public to show that this man is not competent to stand.
Moving on to the Daily Sun. Niger Delta crisis, others. Jonathan opens up. I'm in talks with militants. Meet Buhari. Dogara bribing reps with $25,000. We need to talk about, really, says Jubrin. It's mere blackmail. That's from Zachary. Please forgive me, Obiano tells Obi. Again, EFCC detains Nadi Usman. PDP crisis. Sheriff writes INEC to stop convention. Ground troops invade Arepo Creek. Destroys 140 camps.
And I must commend the military that are working in Arepo. Because as of yesterday, they said they had destroyed about 65. No, day before yesterday, that's Tuesday, they had destroyed about 65 camps and yesterday about 75 camps. And they recovered police uniform bearing corporal ranks. They also recovered military uniforms. They recovered, cartridges, guns. They recovered computers. They even have, the needs. They here
because
now.
If they don't capture men will move to another place and continue their job.
They got ID cards as well. And, you know, what we talk about, the needs that people need. They recovered toiletries and they recovered food items from the camps. The point is that as far as, you know, they are, they are going at them, definitely there will be some running around. And in that process, I'm sure they'll be able to capture them physically.
But moving on to the last paper for today, cereal.
This day,
yes. Jonathan keeps mum on corruption. Cases against former aides and officials. Meet Buhari sues for unity, peace in Niger Delta. Says he makes nocturnal visits to State House, holds meeting with PDP BOT. Gowon backs Nigeria's restructuring, says he did the same in 1967. Says he became head of state by accident. Budget scandal. Clamor for reconvening of House heightens. Military, we are not bothered about Boko Haram leadership change. Troops arrest high-profile sect member. Orubebe in fresh trouble, accused of diverting 1.9 billion naira compensation for residents in East West Road. Now, the story that I want us to take now is not here, but I really can't. We can't avoid talking about Dogara and the bribing scandal. Mm. That's $25,000.
We're out of time. I don't think we should focus on it because it's just mere allegations. Yes. Let them prove. Yes. We're too tired of media trials.
So while we wait for them to prove, we'll wrap up Front Page Review for today. When we return, we discuss setting conditions on whom to marry. Now, some of you would already know what I mean by this if you've been following what is trending on social media. See you after this short break. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back. There's an ongoing debate stirring controversy on social media about whom to or whom not to marry. According to reports, a certain general overseer, one of the biggest churches in Nigeria, while counseling his youth on marriage, said, "Don't marry a girl simply because she can sing. Marry a prayer warrior. If a girl cannot pray for 1 hour, don't marry her. Don't marry a lazy girl who cannot cook. Don't marry a girl who is worldly. If you do, you have carried what you will worship for the rest of your life." He went on further to warn the ladies against accepting marriage proposal by jobless men. He said those who couldn't earn enough income shouldn't marry. What are your thoughts on this? It's really... it's a open house Thursday. So feel free to call in right from now on 070-8068-8014 and you can tweet to us at TVC Connect. Please hashtag your view. And Jimoke will be reading your tweets.
Stop laughing.
Now, I'm an actress.
I'm a little surprised. Why are we not mentioning his name? Everybody else knows who we're talking about. It's Pastor Adeboye, GEO, Redeemed Christian Church of God. We know who he is. And he has a right to his opinion. But people went at him. They attacked him on social media saying that, "Oga, you are 73. In your generation, these rules applied. In our generation, I can marry as a woman, a jobless man, and tomorrow we start our own family business, or he finds a job next tomorrow. A man can decide to marry a woman who doesn't know how to cook. For instance, if you are from the East and you marry a Yoruba woman and your wife only knows how to make Yoruba food, won't you teach her how to do all the ofe owere, all the kainko and things? So that a woman does not know how to cook when you marry her doesn't mean that she cannot learn to cook. So you saying don't marry somebody who doesn't know how to cook as a woman, as a man, don't marry a man who is jobless as a woman. Yes, in those days, but not
I sort of
days.
Feel that it was deliberately taken out of context. You know, when somebody just decides to pick a word and take it, interpret it to suit themselves. Siri, what's your opinion on this?
I thought I was going to come last.
Why?
With apologies.
You are the single man. No, you're the one looking for wife. Are you looking for the one that can pray for 1 hour? 3 hours.
Prayer warrior.
You know, some of these things, people have can have very good skills and share a lot of virtue, as we've seen in some cases. But a year, 2 years into the marriage, some of those things fly out of the window. It's reality. I think that when I thought about this yesterday, it's a very sensitive issue. And again, towing your line of somebody being quoted out of context, that possibility can be taken away. But I have a friend, for instance. She told me that she's from Delta. She married a man from I think, Cross River. So she was cooking all the banga soup, banga, all those things. One Thursday, he told her, see, this thing you're cooking, I'm not enjoying it. Too. By Saturday, his village soup was in front of him. By Saturday.
She made it happen.
She made it happen.
Yes,
I think that's what we should look for when we... Somebody who is willing to learn, somebody who is submissive, somebody who
since
is...
Since we are talking...
Let me just wrap up. You know, somebody who is teachable. Because eventually, since it's coming from the Christian ontology, let me explore that a bit. The man is the head of the home. The woman is... taking the analogy of Christ and the church again, the woman is subject to her husband. They're equal partners in inheriting God's, but again, the man is the head. So eventually, if they can find themselves in those positions and they are comfortable accepting, you know, their roles, I think that it's only a matter of time. If the woman doesn't know how to pray, it is husband's responsibility.
To proper teaching.
Because, you know, today, the devil has given us a different, where we say she's a praying mother, she's a praying, but the husband is the head. No, regardless of the man's spirituality, if he does not have that spirit, he is not eminently qualified to give her direction. That's the, and the Bible says that, you know, if a man cannot provide for his family, he is worse than an infidel. It's not just financial provision. It's all-round total provision. Talk about, I cook very well.
You just nailed something for me in saying that we focus on praying woman and we forget a praying man. As the head, if you cannot rule in all those areas, then you fail.
I'm very happy about what you said, Cyril, about the fact that for me, what I hold on is the fact that if she's teachable, do you understand? And I think it goes both ways in a relationship. It's not one-sided. You know, the most important ingredient to any human being is that teachability. That you're humble enough to accept your fault and you take it and you're teachable. And it's not a function of whether you can pray for 10 hours or 50 hours. But since we're talking about a pastor, I want to take a cue from Galatians chapter 6 and verse 1. It said, brethren, if any person is overtaken in misconduct or sin of any sort, you who are spiritual, that is in bracket, who are responsive to and controlled by the Spirit, set him should set him right and restore and restate him without any sense of superiority and with all gentleness, keeping an attentive eye on yourself, lest you should be tempted also. Now, from a place of authority, I accept that, okay, yes, he's able to see certain things that we, you know, as his, or his church members rather, because I'm not a member of the church, can see. But you see, where you now try to become a lord and master over somebody, telling them what not to do and what to do, I have an issue with that. You should not, even if you are going to say something, say it as a form of advice. Not that you are coming at the person as if you are the person's God. You know, a lot of church members right now, they take the words of their general overseers verbatim as Lord. That is where me, I have an issue. If you are coming and you're talking about it in the form of a counsel, I will take it and I will not have a problem with it. So for me, I'm saying that whatever it is, with all the things he mentioned, these are things that anybody that is wise will know that you need them in your life. So it's not something that is out of this world. He's not saying something that is,
back to,
you know,
when
that
I
is
said
strange.
That it was being taken, it was deliberately being taken out of context.
And because we are sensational
just
people
to
now.
To sensationalize that topic. But because you said, Jumoke mentioned how old he is. This is a 73-year-old man talking to the youth of his church. So you cannot expect that
generations apart.
He's not appealing to them. He's telling them, based on my wealth of experience and what I have, what God has taken me through in life, these are pillars you should focus on in terms of your marriage.
Please, may I say to you that, so somebody, and it was very funny on social media, did a social media poll. Young men, what do you want in your wife? Number one, a prayer warrior. Number two, a good cook. Number three, a submissive wife. Number four, hot sex. And most of the men who took the poll wanted number four. So on their
generation,
own, on their own priority list, it's not even prayer warrior or food or submission. The number two was submission. But somebody now said, wait, so this submission, is he part of telling her, oh yeah, madam, get on the bed?
We have a call. Olajide from Ikorodu, welcome to the show. Jesus. Good morning. what's your take? Good morning. What do you want in a man? What do you want in a woman, rather?
14 years old.
He understands, he understands.
What do you want in a woman, sorry?
All right. In a sharp reaction to what the DJ said, I won't say he's right and I won't say he's wrong. But there are some very important things one needs to know before getting into marriage. I would advise every man out there, if you are not having a legitimate steady income, don't go into marriage. Two, if you cannot feed yourself, your wife, and one other person, that's the child, don't go into marriage. Then, lastly, you must be able to accept the woman you want to get married to the way she is. Wow. Don't be ready to change her by force. You must be tolerant, and you must have sacrifices. When you are mentally fit to go into all these things, then you can be said to be ready for marriage. Yeah. Marriage is not a child's play at all. Nobody is ever ready to get married. Mm. But before you go into it, be prepared.
Thank you, Olajide.
Very well spoken, and I totally agree with you, Olajide, accepting her the way she is. So I heard, my auntie was telling me just over the weekend that a man returned his wife after 15 years of marriage that she cannot cook.
Joe, what has she been cooking over the 15 years?
And my auntie said the only thing she asked the woman's mother is, so what did you say to the man? Did he not date her? Did you not know that she couldn't cook before you married her? That people just give all sorts of flimsy excuses these days for divorce.
Bimpe from Surulere, welcome to the show. Good morning.
Good morning.
What's your take on this?
My take on this, what Pastor Adeboye has said, is an advice, like a counseling to the youth in the church. I am not a member of the church. I am a Muslim.
Okay.
But what he has said, let's look at this. The foundation of Muslim state is in weddings, and after that, what you hear are stories after the wedding. What the man of God has said, if our youth can take it from, I'm not saying submissive, blah, blah, but we have some ladies nowadays, I'm sorry to say, but they cannot even fry eggs.
Fry egg.
And what did you do with a man who cannot even spend some clothes? Most ladies nowadays, they go from bankrolling the wedding, then, oh, because yes, I want to get married, my friends are getting married. Then at the end of the day, you start hearing problems. If you can take a view from this thing that said, these are the three that main issues. A man who cannot feed you, and a woman who can't chat with him, he has to open to a friend.
The love will fly away. Yeah.
Bella, let me take some tweets. Bella Abi Dakun says, thanks for that passage. Don't lord over people's lives, but give them advice because it's their life. Gabriel Adomini says, Adeboye said the truth. With offensive words, marriage is spiritual and shouldn't be measured with today's yardstick. KVM model says, Pastor Adeboye is saying it to make the youth gear up to responsibilities.
Okay. We'll still continue on this topic. After this break, we're going to bring in a guest to help shed more light on what we should look for in marriage, how we should, the criteria for marriage, and if cooking is a requirement for marriage. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back. Really hot topic. Joining us today is a relationship and lifestyle coach, Praise Fowowe. Welcome to the show, Praise. Smoke now, you entered into the heat of one major
you
argument.
You guys are going
to
smoke.
I was so eager to jump into the argument that I didn't even want to even read your name. Because this Oga cereal here is telling me that a woman's job must be able to cook. A woman must be able to cook
in marriage. No, that
is a condition for marriage. And honestly, I don't agree with him. And I don't agree with a woman's condition because I feel that we're already in a patriarchal society that says that a woman must be subservient in every way. Now, putting cooking as part of the requirements.
Requirement is the word, not condition.
Exactly. Requirements.
Exactly. That's cereal.
Yes.
Right? Put it. Yes. Now, we need to understand things and how we process things. Cooking is not an end. Cooking is a means to an end.
Thank you.
It's a process that leads to
eating.
What a human being needs is not even cooking. What a human being needs is food.
Oh.
Now, so when you process it from that angle, now who does the cooking would not matter.
That,
if what human being needs is food. Right? So it cannot be. So for example, then we also have to conceptualize and say, are we talking about first world, second world, third world nation? Right? If you live in a first world nation where your income is n per hour, right, does this rule appear? How do we process these things? So if we have agreed that what human beings need is food, right? Then we can now begin to look at it to say, how is the cooking done? If it's food that you need, then there are several options.
May I interrupt you, sir? Yeah. My first question to you was going to be that why have we turned women to cooking utensils when women can be much more than that? You have answered that already. Yeah. But my follow-up question, which I have forgotten now, I will address to you later.
Yeah. Now, I heard you guys talk about what Daddy Joe said.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when I first, I had to listen to the entire thing. And trust me, if you listen to it properly, now, Daddy Joe was addressing his children. In fact, I used the word my children. Now, if a man who is a father is talking to his children, he's also assumed that he has a culture, right, that he wants his children to adhere to. Now, so those are his children. He did not say, oh, ye Nigerians. He did not say, oh, ye Africans. Oh, ye global. He never said that. His children. Now, if those laws are okay for his children, you can't blame him. Now, one thing I also would like to look at is, I would look beyond what has been said to the intention now, and which is very important, because I've seen a lot of people bash the man. I do not, we're Africans, I do not think that's proper. Yeah. Now, to the intention, you ask the question, is the intention meant to create divorce? Is it meant to break homes? Mm-hmm. Is it meant to, now if the intention is
to meant to crystallize the relationship.
Crystallize the relationship and make it fine, then it's fine within the context of his children, right? Because, for me, I mean, I saw it to my wife yesterday. I've been married for 10 years. I said, I've never seen you pray for one hour.
Non-stop.
I've never done 1 hour. And it also depends on what we call prayers. I don't think I can have the temperament to do 1 hour non-stop, right? What I have the temperament to do is to think 6 hours non-stop, right? Wherein thinking is aligned with divine, right? Which could be a form of prayer. Now, having said that, let's leave what Daddy Joe has said, because I believe it was said to his own children, right? If you are not within that context, you are not his child. In fact, if there was no video, you wouldn't have heard, right? Because it was a family meeting.
Yeah,
right. So, I mean, for you intruding into what people were discussing in their family, you say this is a family culture, it's unmeable to start with. So it's none of your business. No, so can we come back to the issues to now say, do you need to cook or whatever? I believe human beings needs to cook. Human beings. Now, kitchen is not a woman's place.
Thank you.
Right? Kitchen is meant for human beings. If kitchen had been for women, then every house built, sold to a man, they would have detached the kitchen. To now say, when you have a wife, you can reattach by the kitchen with the woman. Right? So every house comes with a kitchen to prove that this is a place where cooking is done for human beings to eat. So, in fact, my own rule, I said to single girls, never marry a guy who can't cook.
Abby,
that's my own rule.
I want breakfast in bed too now.
He's going to turn you to a cook. And you see, the biggest problem we have is this. And I see that a lot of singles, you see a lot of singles, mature single girls, and they come to me and say, Praise, I can't even see a man to marry me. And this girl has built herself, developed a career, traveled for several trainings, as in she's just high up there. Now, so
loaded.
Now, by the time I analyzed the lady, I said, have you realized that? You have, by your training, you are no longer a third world lady. You are a first world lady looking for a husband among third world men.
Oh,
right. By the training you have given to yourself, what you have developed the capacity to do won't even permit you to be saying in the kitchen.
Brings me to a question.
Ryo is tweeting, oh, for the first time, madam, keep on enjoying your holiday. She said, for me, my husband prefers I don't stay in the kitchen. So cooking was not a requirement for my marriage. That's from Mariah Falabi Brown.
I want to bring you to the poll that Jumoke said went on online. Mm. And seeing the mindset of this generation.
Our youth of today.
Of today. Yes. The focus is on sexual relation.
I have a
as
problem with that
to
as well.
Others. Yeah. Isn't this linked to why we are having the higher rate of divorce?
We won't have it. Because people don't understand that the pillars, and he said a few things that I would really disagree with. The pillars of a marriage is hinged on the prerequisite that you are first of all a man and a woman. Mm. Now those things are identity. Husband and wife are optional roles. Mm. Not every man will become a husband, not every woman will become a wife. Mm. So that those roles comes with their own role descriptions, right? To now say, when we are coming together to form a family, where it's assumed that you are forming a team. Mm. Now, in a team, there are roles. You can be a goalkeeper. Mm. You can be a striker. However, there are situations wherein, let's say your wife is a goalkeeper. So let's say she looks like that's a kitchen area. Where your goalkeeper has been dribbled and the ball is going towards your net. Do you say, because I am not the goalkeeper?
You won't run to the net.
Because players don't win or lose matches. Teams win or lose matches. Unfortunately, a lot of African men are scoring own goals against their family. Mm. In their bid to promote culture, and let's say this, culture is the way of life of a people, right? Now, it means that culture can be manipulated, right? Mm. Now, the people who made those way of life, where did they gather? Whatever did they consult? Because the original African man in the night, 1100, 200, he was a man, 1202. If you had asked him, will a woman ever own a company? He will tell you no.
No,
a woman from where? Because his perception of a woman is a thing that must be used, not a being that must be respected. Mm. Now, if you go back to the etymology of the word man, in that etymology, original etymology, you will find the word not even gender-centric, you will find humanity or mankind, which is now expressed in two genders, male, female. So before even marriage at all, I have a problem with men who look at a woman they are not married to and they expect submission, they expect her to cook, they expect her to do so many things.
God bless
now that is not correct.
How do we bring this, your ideology, into the Nigerian third world?
It's not my ideology.
No, okay, this is a very fantastic
what we need to do is to now begin to, that's why we teach family system engineering, wherein we are now teaching people to say, can you look at a woman? You met her at the point of getting married to her, dating her, when you were doing all the chores, you were doing all these things. If you are told her that as we are getting to marriage, I will not cook again, I will retire from kitchen, you will cook even when you are pregnant, even when you are sick, you must cook for me. Will she go ahead to say yes to you? She will not. It means you tricked her. And I'm an advocate for, before we step into marriage, can we agree on how we're going to live our life and document it?
Yes.
Can we do that?
Phrase, you always say this, that we should document our intentions.
Yes.
But the issue is that, you see, in reality, like what Cyril said, 2 years down the line, do you understand? There's a sense of, I know the person, over familiarity, even in marriage. That you begin to just look at the person and the spark, the love and whatever that was there, it just dies down. But I have a problem right now. Because even from the mindset of the GEO, talking in that light of saying cooking and all that, it is deeper than the issues that we are seeing. You said something about culture, which I totally agree with you. So how do we begin to change the culture? And now start to shape it in the way that
let me give you a scenario.
You know, it becomes the acceptable culture.
It's when we need to begin to promote a thinking Africa. Let me give you a scenario. A lady said to me that her parents, she couldn't get married because from the eastern part, because they were asking for bride price of about 1.2 million, right? So she said her father, so I said, go and ask your father who agreed this figure, right? So the father said the gods in their village. Now I said these same gods used to accept palm wine and cowries before.
In those days.
Where did they now meet to graduate to bellies and dollars? Right? So you realize that human beings come together and they decide to change things. So we need to become a new generation
ancestors. Would it not be seen as we are being rebellious?
No. You are not rebellious, whatever you do in your home. If you come to my house, for example, for washing up plates is everyone's duty. I've done that in 10 years, right? You finish your dish.
My house is everybody's duty.
And the first person to get into the kitchen cooks. My wife, in fact, If you don't have expectation, you cannot be disappointed.
When
I was coming to marriage, I had no expectation for a woman cooking for me because I can fix my meals. I had no expectation of someone cleaning my house because I was doing that as a single person. Right? If you don't do that, that's when you don't have expectation. If you were living alone, so you see some men, African men, you say because you mopped the floor, your wife didn't say thank you. When you were single and you were mopping your room, who was saying thank you?
But let me.
There is no goodness in you. If what a woman is doing is what is making you to change, what is making you to react, you are not yet a proper man before you step into that role of a husband. And what we have to understand is this. A lot of people became husband simply because they were told that once you're out of school, you have a job, the next thing is to become a husband. So they don't understand the roles.
Prepared.
They don't understand the tenets of fatherhood. Hmm. So because they don't have an identity,
Please. Right?
Anything that looks like it confronts their identity, they fight it. And that's why human being, Please. A man, must never dominate another human being. Right? The moment you want to have dominion over another human being, that other human being has become the beast of the field, the best of the air, everything that hovers upon the surface of the deep. Because you are only allowed to have dominion over things.
Thank
not
you.
Not now, human how, being. Please, praise. You're going to cause a lot of revolution.
Yes.
Because women are listening and getting liberated, but men are not happy about this. Can you break down so that there's a lesson from this? For a man that is already cultured and engineered to see that a woman must do this, how do we start breaking it down
from that
mindset of respecting a woman, seeing it as we are in this together?
You see, the challenge, the difference is this, and let me situate that so that someone doesn't go home to cause trouble. As a woman, right, you can command, you can instruct. As a wife, you suggest.
Thank you.
That's where role is different from identity.
Thank you.
Right, because the word wife is the word Isa, right? From etymology point of view, and you can go and study these things. Isa means the kind of help that only God could have supplied. If you check Isa in Greek, it's the word parakletos, which is the same word used for the Holy Spirit, right?
So you suggest
as a wife. Now, if you can't, and the problem that happens most times is, and you don't blame the women because no one has taught them. So this woman handles 20 staffs at work. She's giving them command.
So when she steps home,
she's forgotten to switch back to her feminine mode, which is not easy.
We'll take a break right now. Let us digest what we have just said. We'll take a quick break. When we return, we'll continue in this Isa. Welcome back to the show. We'll first take the call from Dr. Effiom. Welcome to the show, Dr. Effiom, all the way from Badagry. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning.
What's your take on this discussion we've been having?
What the man say already, Pastor Adeboye, it's not okay on my own understanding. At least we are living in a modern world. Not within this world. So, whereby you need to tolerate each other as a Christian, irrespective of how it is, you're supposed to tolerate each other. If your wife doesn't know how to cook, you teach your wife how to cook. If you don't know how to cook, you teach how to do that. You are living in the modern day world. And your brother that is there now, who's giving counsel concerning.
Praise for Owen.
Talking to his own people. Said Adeboye was talking to his own people as a children. But he forgot that they use media whereby everybody will hear it. And most people would like to adopt to what you say. There will be problems. So my own view of it is that we should apply that open in
part. Please hold on. Please. I need praise to address. Tokwe already mentioned that men are going to be attacking what you're saying. Baba the Baba is a comedian, says, motivational speakers have succeeded in making women useless. Even jobless women don't do house chores. And I've seen several tweets, sort of saying the same thing, like, you're coming and just saying all sorts of things that going to, I want you to address this.
Now, the challenge in Africa is, we have led a life of a thinking pattern which has not helped us, and that's why till date we've not flown any plane, we've not invented anything, right? We are users of what is brought in. So you hear us say things like, all the things they are saying is first world, all these Americans. But everything we're using Americans, everything we're using are first world nations, all our cars, right? Why don't we keep driving a camel or walking barefoot?
So there's something they're doing right.
There's something they're doing right. There are good parts of our culture, which is where we are saying, for example, my son has been taught how to cook.
My daughter
knows how to cook. So that we have to become new generation of parents, such that when, because you see, something is faulty when you are going into marriage with the mentality of someone must cook for me. You need a cook, not a wife.
Mm. Abi, thank you. We have a call. Adeleke from Alimosho. Welcome to the show. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning to everybody.
Good morning.
Yeah, I think I'm not, and I can never support Pastor Adeboye for what he said about marriage. Because let's forget about marriage in Nigeria for now, with the situation of the country. See, I personally, I attended CMS Grammar School in Bariga. I wasn't paying a dime as school fees, tuition fee then. Now, look at the situation of the country. From CMS Grammar School, I went to the University of Lagos. I was paying 35 naira as tuition fee. Jumoke can testify to that. I was paying 35 naira. I entered, again, admission into Unilag like 1996, and I finished 99 to 2000. Now, look at the problem of the country. They are not talking, the same grammar school I'm talking about, it was formed by the missionary.
Mm.
And we weren't paying a dime. Now, look at the university, the so-called private university by all these churches. Instead of Pastor Adeboye and other pastors to come together and think about how they could, you know, be of help to the government by reducing the tuition fee of their school, they are talking about marriage. What is marriage? Marriage. It's none of his business. If my wife does not know how to cook, it's possible for me to teach my wife. Since I love her, this is how to cook. This is what I like. How can you be telling us that she don't? Thank you.
I'm excited about what Adeleke said. And honestly speaking, I feel for me, if my husband, it's not like he cannot go to the kitchen. My children cook, my husband cooks. But the truth is that most times when he asks me to make something for him, it's coming from a place of love.
And respect
that, come, I've missed your food, I really want you to cook for me. So you see, instead of, it's not everything that the man said that is totally out of this world that people want to now strangle him for. I feel that if a relationship is built on love, respect, you know, and there's a very, very strong communication in that marriage, doing things for each other will not be a problem. It is when people now start to put mouth where it does not concern them, and you now start listening to people outside, that's when you begin to have hitches in your marriage. Because everything that he has said, it is what keeps the bond together. If your husband is eating your food every day, trust me, he will continue to love you. He will continue to, there's a connection between
I think people don't know that the geo, because if you know that the geo, you will know that at least I'm a bit close to mommy. Mm. I know that the geo is domesticated. So, and that's why I'm taking things out of context and the intention. I think the intention is what I would look at. And based on the intention, I think it's trying to communicate. I can excuse him, but we need to now focus on the real issue.
Yes, and you were driving home a point about the cultural influences of the man. Like Jumoke was asking, are we not now turning women to say rebel against
you know the bigger challenge is, if you ask who is a Yoruba person, when was the last time you went for a naming ceremony? We want to say we are Yorubas. When was the last time you went for a naming ceremony and they named the child Ige or Idowu
or
Alaba or something? These things have, so we take the parts of the Western that we think favors us, then we leave then we don't want, and it's still because we need to ask, have we turned around this world? Have we created a better world with everything we want to hold on to?
Abi, Ime from Uyo, welcome to the show. Good morning.
Good morning, all of you there.
Yeah, good morning. Welcome to the show.
And please, I think you people are making a mistake. Not what Adeboye means. You see, there are some women, they will wake up in the morning, they will sit in their bed. At the house care, please go and buy the baby. Go and prepare their food. Go and make tea for her. And they will sat down there watching Telemundo. Watching
The example was detailed. Telemundo.
Adeboyo means he is not like you just describing all those things. He is trying to advise the youth to step up of their game.
That's the intention. Yes.
True.
Thank you.
I agree with you.
Please, may I use myself as an example to say that when I read what he said, I just laughed. That in my spiritual growth with God, now I can pray for 3 hours. I have many devotional books. I'll be there 3 hours.
Let me even shock you. You want to pray for 3 hours? How does God rate hours?
Abi.
Olobato.
The content.
God doesn't live by 24 hours.
You can do 1 hour prayer. You say one day. Has no content.
There was a time I do some seasonal fasting, you know. So I done 3 days, and I said, let me just continue. Let me do 7 days. Like, I'm not feeling these 3 days. The fourth day, God told me to stop fasting. So, I mean, you must be spiritual.
You know how God deals with it. I think spirituality is what that the Jew is trying to say. People are becoming very, very carnal. I think so. That intention point of view is what we must look at, because
we need to take some tweets and round.
And we have a lot of people do the best they can. I mean,
with what they know, and from the map of the world,
and they are coming also with the best intentions, even if they are doing something evil.
Absolutely,
there is always a good intention for it. DJ Pumping says, "Oga praise, please don't cause problem between intending couples. Women are expected to cook. It's not a must, but don't say house help must be the one to cook." Joseph,
what about man? What about the man? He mustn't cook.
Joseph Miami says, your guest and his types are deceiving many young girls in their marriages, and their marriages are cashing daily. Cooking is a good quality. Okushaga says, just 1996, yeah, you pay 35 naira, and in 2016 is more than that. Ademiroju says, what if she refuses to learn how to cook? After all, you knew she couldn't cook before you married
her. Ezekiel Shegai says, I will confess, I am ignorantly guilty of a couple of points raised by your guest. Once again, religion and culture. And the line is not
fair. Bella says, no one says women shouldn't cook, but we're saying cooking should not be a criteria.
Human beings should cook.
Marriage.
Human beings should cook.
Okay. Olawumi says, from ages past, cooking is part of women's function. Men can only assist. All men can't look like you do. Save your marriage, women.
Well, on that note, I think we've learned a whole lot.
Ami says, my Yoruba people says, Olobelo loko, a woman who cooks is the pride of a man.
Okay. But I think what we've learned, and we mustn't let go of today, that everybody should know, is that the family, like from what Prey said, we're working towards achieving
a team win.
It's a team win. So if your wife is weak in an area, step up and help out. It is not to your advantage that you shame your wife and break down the team.
Your husband
also. So please, marriages, focus on the team. Husband feeling, wife feeling. And if you're about to get married, take what Pastor Adeboye said on one hand, and listen to what we said on the other hand. Merge it together and make the best decision for yourself, because you are the one in that marriage. It is not Pastor Adeboye or any of us here. So you make the final decision and be ready to live with it.
Professional helps as well.
You can seek professional help. Well, I hope you've learned a lot. You can also go to YouTube to watch previous episodes by searching for TVC Entertainment. Scroll through and search for Your View. It's so good to have Praise in the house. Thank you so much, Cyril. Thank you, co-host. Thank you all for watching. Have a great day. Bye-bye.
Bye.